State of Hawaii Dengue Fever Warning. Vector control teams have responded and will continue to be active in the Haleiwa area on Oahu's North Shore. Dengue fever is a mosquito-borne viral disease occurring in tropical and subtropical areas. Those who become infected with the virus a second time are at a significantly greater risk of developing severe disease. Warning for the public. The public is urged to take additional precautions to protect themselves from mosquito bites and to stop mosquitoes from breeding. Symptoms are high fever, rash, and muscle and joint pain. In severe cases, there is serious bleeding and shock, which can be life-threatening. Treatment includes fluids and pain relievers. Severe cases require hospital care. The area where the case was reported experiences high traffic of visitors and tourists. Highly dense populations of Aedes albopictus mosquitoes, a vector of dengue virus, were identified around the residence where the case was found and the surrounding area. The initial vector control response resulted in a marked reduction of mosquitoes around the case residence. iturbonews.com. The Hawaii Department of Health will continue to monitor mosquito numbers in this area and take additional measures as needed. Signage will be posted to educate the public on protecting themselves and preventing transmission. How to reduce the spread of dengue fever? The DOH asks for support in reducing the potential for the spread of dengue by transmission. Residents, visitors, and businesses can take the following steps. Apply mosquito repellent on exposed skin, especially if outdoors. Repellent should be registered with the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, and contain 20-30% DEET, active ingredient. Other alternative active ingredients may include picaridin, oil of lemon eucalyptus, or IR3535. Click here to find the insect repellent that is right for you. Wear loose-fitting clothes, long sleeves and pants that cover your skin. Keep mosquitoes out of your home or business by keeping doors closed or screens in good repair. Dump any standing water in or around your residence or business to eliminate potential breeding sites. This includes removing rainwater collected in buckets, flower pots, used tires, or even plants such as bromeliads. The symptoms of dengue fever. Symptoms of dengue typically may be mild or severe and include fever, nausea, vomiting, rash, and body aches. Symptoms usually last 2 to 7 days, and although severe and even life-threatening illnesses can occur, most people can recover after about a week. The Department of Health is asking people, if they are experiencing any of the symptoms listed above, to see their doctor or healthcare provider and inform them that they were in an area where a case of dengue virus was confirmed. Dengue virus is spread from infected person to person through mosquito bites. While Hawaii is home to the type of mosquitoes that can carry dengue, the disease is not established in Hawaii. Of the 10 dengue cases reported in Hawaii since January 1, 2023, to present, 5 had traveled to Central or South America, and 5 had traveled to Asia. Anyone who travels to an area with dengue is at risk for infection. The CDC advises travelers to practice usual precautions when traveling to dengue risk areas. How to protect from dengue fever. This includes using an EPA-registered insect repellent, wearing long-sleeved shirts and long pants outdoors, and sleeping in an air-conditioned room or room with properly fitted window screens or under an insecticide-treated bed net. Some countries are reporting increased numbers of cases, so it is essential, 4 to 6 weeks before travel, to review country-specific travel information for the most up-to-date guidance on dengue risk and prevention measures for that country. Travelers returning from an area with a risk of dengue should take steps to prevent mosquito bites for 3 weeks, and if symptoms of dengue develop within 2 weeks upon return, they should seek medical evaluation. For more information, please visit the Disease Outbreak Control Division, DOCD, website and Vector Control Branch, VCB, website.